Welcome to Community Concerts at Second's 35th season of world-class music, offered free to all. Serving our hometown of Baltimore and the wider region through live and virtual events, the series is presented at Second Presbyterian Church and was founded by Margaret Budd in 1987. Community Concerts at Second is an independent, nonprofit organization, and our mission is to enrich our community by providing free professional musical experiences of lasting artistic value. Today's concert is made possible by you, our audience, and our donors. Since we do not charge admission to our concerts, we rely upon contributions from you, our audience. Please consider making a contribution to the concert series online at cc2nd.org or by texting cc2 to the number 44321. We thank you for your attention and your support, and we hope you enjoy today's concert.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you. My name is John Warshawski. I'm the treasurer of Community Concerts at Second, and I'm pleased to welcome you to tonight's Chamber Music by Candlelight concert featuring musicians from the Baltimore Symphony Orchestra. Before I go any further, I would like to inform you of a schedule change. We regrettably have postponed our next concert, which was scheduled to take place on November 7th, and to feature the renowned soprano, Ms. Janice Chandler-Edeme. We hope to reschedule her concert when the current COVID-related masking requirements no longer present an impediment to her singing. Our next concert will be in 4 weeks on November 21st, and it will again feature musicians from the Baltimore Symphony Orchestra. Community Concerts at Second is now in its 35th season, and an indispensable partner for us through all that time has been, of course, Second Presbyterian Church. We are so indebted to their congregation, their staff, and their leadership, and we thank them for making our program possible. Our organization has always sought to present live concerts for the Baltimore community, and we have never charged admission, allowing us to fulfill our mission of music for all and free to all. I believe we will never charge admission for our concerts because we are committed to keeping our programs accessible to everyone and without a cost to attend. Our costs are real, however, and we do rely on the generous support of individual donors, granting organizations, and sponsors. In fact, individual donors comprise our single largest group of funders, and they enable us to present on the order of 16 first-class concerts every season. If you have made a contribution to Community Concerts at Second, perhaps at the door or otherwise, we thank you truly. If you have not made a contribution, and this is important, if you are able to do so, we ask you to consider supporting Community Concerts at Second. You can do so in a number of ways, including making a donation through our website, www.csecond.org, or you can make a donation at the door where our volunteers can accept cash, checks, and process credit and debit cards. And now that I've fulfilled my finance-driven duties as treasurer of this organization, I move on to the enjoyable task of asking you all to please take a moment to silence your mobile phones and to turn off your other electronic devices, at least silence them like beeping watches. It is now our genuine pleasure and honor to present this evening's Chamber Music by Candlelight Concert, featuring the world-class musicians of the Baltimore Symphony Orchestra. Thank you.
We're going to get right into it. These are some miniatures by William Grant Still. This first one, and they all have little sort of preambles by the composer. And rather than look over your shoulder, I am getting my own copy to read. So this one, the first one is called I Ride an Old Paint. This cowboy tune comes from Santa Fe, New Mexico. It was sung by a rider who so loved his horse that he begged that on his death, his bones should be tied to the horse and the two of them set wandering with their faces turned westward. Does this turn off? Thank you. Before we started, we had a little idea fest on how we could make this more awkward. We didn't tell them that we needed the microphone after every single movement. So the second movement is called Adolorido, and the introduction goes as follows. Lacking newspapers, the Mexican natives outside the cities invented the corrido, corresponding to the European ballad, to convey to others the news of heroic deeds, accidents, love affairs, and so on. Adolorido is such a news song coming from the Bajío, or low country, hot country around the state of Guanajuato. It tells of sadness over being betrayed by an ungrateful woman.
Next movement, Jesus is a Rock in the Weary Land. This Negro spiritual differs in character from those generally arranged for singers. Here, it is given a rhythmic treatment to correspond to the way it would be heard in some of the more primitive churches today.
Thank you.
Yaravi. In this Quechua tongue, which is a language of the ancient Incas, Yaravi means lament. Known in Peru as a song of long ago, this poignant melody speaks of the absence of a dear one. A frog went a-courtin'. There are many versions of this lilting tune, each one varying with the particular singer. The composer first heard it in a little village close to the mountainous section in Kentucky and was told that it came from Virginia. Other regions also claim it as indigenous to them. The basic song is said to have been in continuous use for more than 400 years. Thank you.
I think I'll hold on to it now since it's just me. So these pieces you're about to hear are probably not super familiar outside the Broadway stage. About 5 years ago in 2015, 6 years ago, I guess, the pianist Anthony DeMare commissioned a whole lot of composers. I don't actually know how many, but it's three books, basically, very thick books worth of transcriptions for piano or arrangements or free arrangements or improvisations on certain themes, all by Stephen Sondheim. And it's actually a treasure trove. It's quite amazing. He had everyone from Wynton Marsalis to Steve Reich, and every person in between you could possibly imagine, current living composers writing these pieces. And I'm going to do three of them for you tonight. I'm going to start with one of my absolute favorite songs from one of my absolute favorite Sondheim shows. It's called No One Is Alone. It is from Into the Woods. So the arrangement is by the great jazz pianist Fred Hirsch. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, they're all very different. I mean, just take a listen to that album at some point if you're into this stuff. The next one, very different, also much quicker. So I'm going to take my jacket off for this one. This is called, it's by Jake Heggie, who is very known for his art songs and operas these days. A really very, very lyrical composer. This one is called I'm Excited. No, You're Not.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, Jake was not messing around. The last one I'm going to play, the third one I'm going to play, is actually by the commissioner himself, not a police person, the person who commissioned all these composers, Anthony Demare, the pianist. And this is actually another, I always say pretty much every Sondheim song is my favorite Sondheim song, but I suppose I could narrow it down if forced to, but this is truly another one of my favorites. It's actually a few different songs, but it features mainly Sunday, from Sunday in the Park with George, which for my money is one of the most incredible pieces of art that exists. I think anyone who's involved in the arts in any way should know that piece. In any case, this is Anthony's, he called it Sunday in the Park Passages. I think it's very appropriate because it's Sunday.
evening. Thank you. Ooh, is this on? I'll just speak loudly.
Thank you so much for having us here this evening. Jacob and I are really excited to be playing some Mozart for you next. Surprisingly, Mozart only wrote two duets for violin and viola. I say surprisingly because, as we know, Mozart was a very fine violinist and violist. He, of course, wrote the beautiful Sinfonia Concertante for this instrumentation as soloists. And during the classical era, many composers were writing for this instrumentation. It was a very popular genre. And so it's kind of unusual that he wasn't really digging into this genre more. We only have these pieces by Mozart because of his dear friend, Michael Haydn, who was the younger brother of, yes, Joseph Haydn. Michael Haydn was also a composer, and he had been commissioned by some archduke, as you did back in the day, to write a collection of six duos for violin and viola, and due to an illness, he only completed four, and then he was not going to be able to finish the collection, and therefore he wasn't going to get his commission money if he didn't finish this collection. So as a favor, Mozart decided he would be sneaky and write the final two duos for violin and viola to kind of pass it off as Michael Haydn's. Well, these two works became much more popular than Michael Haydn's original pieces, sadly, but they truly are wonderful. The first duo by Mozart is in G major, and the one we're going to play for you tonight is in B flat major. The work is in three movements. The first is a lovely allegro that begins with a beautiful, slow, lyrical introduction. The second movement is this lilting, slow, kind of Siciliano dance in which the violin plays a beautiful ornamented tune on top of these very gentle rocking chords in the viola. And then the final movement is a theme in variations in which Mozart really highlights the virtuosity of both instruments. So Jacob and I have had a lot of fun putting this together for you this evening. I think it's far less played than the first duo sonata in G major, but I think it has a lot of heart. So we hope you enjoy Mozart's duo for violin and viola in B flat major. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you all for joining us here today for our 2021-2022 season of live and digitally streamed concerts. Please remember that we do not charge admission for any of our events, which are made possible by donations from you, our audience. Please consider making a contribution to the series online at cc2nd.org or by texting cc2 to the number 44321. We appreciate your support in helping us to provide world-class music free to all members of the Baltimore community and beyond.